Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I'll be starting a new little mini series called What's in the Box? And basically I'm going to be just unboxing subscription boxes and letting you guys know what I think of them. So for today's video, I'll be doing the Cook Homemade subscription box. How this one works is every week you get we've got a little visitor here. So how this box works is every week they send you a box with like ready to cook type meals. They send you all the ingredients you need for the meal, and you have the option to choose like a one meal for a family or two meals for two people. And two meals for two people. And I chose the one two meals for two people, and I also chose the vegetarian box. Okay, so I'll go ahead and we'll quickly show you what the contents are, and then we'll go ahead and try out the recipes later on in this video. Okay, so just opening the box, first thing I see here is, let's see. So there's just like a little like welcome letter there. I don't even know if you guys can even read that. That is quite tiny. Okay, and then so it looks like the two meals in this box are the vegetable chickpea curry bowl with basmati rice. What does that look like? Hopefully it'll come out looking like that. That looks delicious. And the other one is the meatless quinoa lentil meatloaf with maple roasted butternut squash. I'm not a super fan of meatloaf, but we will see how this turns out. I do like chickpea lentils, so... Or quinoa lentils, chickpeas and quinoa. Okay, let's go... Oh, and then one more thing. It comes with... It looks like a little coloring book. And I don't have kids, so I don't know what I'm going to do with this. Alright, let's go into this. So opening the box here, it's just packed with like a little insulation barrier. And by the way, this shipped like super quick. Like I got the email telling me that it was shipped on Monday, and then it arrived Tuesday morning, and it had like the tracking number and everything, which I really like. Okay, so we've got some ice pack. It looks like this is a rose. Smell all the spices. Okay. So we've got some chickpeas. I'm sure you guys know what chickpeas look like. At least I hope so. I'll just kind of quickly go through these contents. So we've got the basmati rice, one yellow onion, which actually, it just looks like it's peeling. Like, it didn't look that good at first sight, but it's just kind of peeling a little bit on the skin. A whole lot of curry powder. We've got some broccoli, some bamboo shoots, sweet potato. I like how everything is labeled. That's really nice. Because sometimes I've tried other types of boxes like this before, and things are not quite labeled. I'm not quite sure what to grab if it's like an item I'm not familiar with. We've got some coconut milk. We've got some fresh carrots, a lime, some cilantro, some baby bell peppers. Oh, I think that was all for one recipe. Yeah, because there's like another layer of cardboard. So I'm assuming this is all for one, probably the chickpea curry one. So I'm just gonna shove that aside. Okay, so now for the rest of the items, we have some mushrooms. chili, that's how they separated these. Some red lentils. Some butternut squash. Looks like some soy sauce. Again, this is probably more of a travel size container there. some celery. And looks like some ketchup. maple syrup. We got some Dijon mustard. Some pinto crumbs. Quite a bit of items. Garlic. Some quinoa. And some thyme. Looks like, yeah, just right. Oh yeah, super great. You guys can totally see my hands over here. Okay, looks like that is everything. Alright, we'll go ahead and get cooking now. Homemade box, and I did the meatless quinoa lentil meatloaf with the maple roasted butternut squash. And just as I was cooking it, I felt like some of the instructions were a little unclear. The biggest one that I was kind of confused on was it's said to put the meatloaf mixture into that loaf pan, and then on the next step it said to place the butternut squash next to the meatloaf on a cooking like a baking sheet. So I'm assuming that the loaf pan was just to help form the meatloaf, but I poured it onto the baking sheet just because that's what the picture has, and I figure that's going to work, so hopefully that turns out okay. It's currently in the oven, so it bakes for about 30 minutes, that's what the instructions say. I'd say it probably took me maybe like 20 to 30 minutes to get all that prepped and put together before putting it in the oven. It's been smelling really, really good. Like, as soon as I started cooking those onions and celery and the mushrooms, it gave off a really nice smell. So it actually smells delicious, and I'm excited to try it. And that time that I threw in as well, I felt like just kind of put the icing on the cake. Like, it just, my whole kitchen smells amazing. One of the things I don't like also is how many dishes I got dirty. So you can kind of see here a little bit. Let's see if I have the pans, and then all of these in the sink, pretty much. Like, I got another pan in there. And then plus I have the baking sheet that is actually in the oven. So, when I've tried other type of subscription boxes, in the, like, mail type cooking subscription boxes in the past, I usually don't dirty as many things. I usually just have, like, a mixing bowl and maybe something to cook with, like a pan or, like, a baking sheet or something. So, yeah, that was, so I got a lot of dishes to do, but luckily, you know, that will be in the oven for 30 minutes, so I can go ahead and start my dishes, and we'll see how it comes out. Okay, so this is the finished product. I think it looks pretty dang close to that picture, pretty similar.
Go ahead and do a taste test to see how everything turns out. So, butternut squash. Super delicious. Could use a little bit more maple syrup for a little sweeter, but it's really good. Now for the meatloaf. And I'm not a super huge fan of meatloaf just because I don't eat a lot of like beef, but all the ingredients that were in this, like, I actually really enjoy eating, so we'll see how it comes out. That's really good. That's my Lucy there in the background. That is actually really, really good. It has kind of like a, I wouldn't say mushy because of like the quinoa and the lentils, but then it also has like a lot of texture from like the walnuts and